What is good, guys? I'm here with another OT playoff match. We got Zutrez versus Meeps. Unfortunately, I missed this live. This is still live, but we have to rewatch the first 16 turns. And I recorded over it because I couldn't live narrate. Yeah. So this is just crazy. Just watch this game, guys. Like, I can't really narrate much because they play fast as fuck. And they'll be rewatching the turns as well. So he goes hard for SD, knowing that the Coco can't oak him. And then the Coco is scared out and he goes for Z's Sky Strike. And Mantine is gone. Now he goes, Meeps brings out his Lele here. And this is a plus two lander, so Meeps is not playing around. He's just attacking what's in front of him. And there's a free switch into Majorna. So now, Zutrez, he just fires off a floor cannon here. Gets some juicy damage on the Coco. I don't know. Maybe he's not Lightning Rod. But he's probably not Lightning Rod. I don't know. He should be Lightning Rod. But yeah, Meeps volts, which is for some reason, it's pretty obvious to me that Zutrez Merrick is Lightning Rod. Gets a defense drop there, and watch this play, guys. He switches out. I don't know if he scouted for a knockoff or if he pressed, maybe he just predicted synthesis, but this covers all options. He gets an attack boost if the knockoffs comes out, and if the synthesis comes out, he still scares off the Venusaur. And now he just Magiwolves, goes for Zen Head, but kills the Venusaur. I mean, Meeps doesn't have a switch and just got a kill. And yeah, he goes on a scarf later here. Yeah, it's basically confirmed that it's scarf if he brings it out on the Gallade. So I assume he's gonna double switch here, Britain the Merrick, exactly, really nice play. And he has no Earthquake resist, so you can just click Earthquake here. It does a lot to the type of Lele. Now Meeps has really in the back, so he has to make some plays to come back. So he goes in the Coco on the... Oh, he could, he just goes into the Lele. So maybe Zutrez made a good middle ground play there, I don't know. I can't really think about that play. I thought he would just go Majorna, but he went Thing instead. But yeah, really nice play into Coco, but Zutrez is a fucking god. He knows that he has the Lightning Rod Merrick in the back, so he's probably not going for T-Bolt. And Meeps is in the back, so he has to play aggressive, and Zutrez stays in. I don't think it was necessary at that point, but he just stunned it. And watch this play, guys. He goes hard into Merrick on the Z Nature Power that turns into Gigavolt Havoc. Even though he had a Mantine. I mean, the Mantine was in, but like... That was just crazy. Like, I don't know if is he some god? Like, how did he know? Like, he didn't even have to make any of those plays. And yeah, he was just sacking the Merrick probably, but yeah, he got a kill because Meeps tried to double out. At that point, it didn't matter. The game was over anyway. But yeah, I have some personal issues going on, so my narration is probably the kind of ass. But it's also because I have to. Like, they're playing so fucking fast. It was just a beatdown. This was game one. And yeah, we're back with game two. For game two, I only missed four turns. And you guys will see right now, this is gonna be another fast game. I obviously won't spoil if this is gonna be a game 3, but that is, game 1 was a complete beatdown. People didn't know much about Zutrez. He qualified with some weird team where he used like Assault Vest, Landris, and Chansey offense. He doesn't only use that team, he also used other teams, but that's crazy. Now, it was really cool to see that Gallade get some usage. But yeah, we're here with game 2. I'm rewatching the first few turns real quick for you guys, because I also missed the beginning. So he leads off with the Coco, and this time he just goes for a safe wild charge, because in game 1 he played somewhat aggressive. And yeah, he makes a really good play here. He goes for Taunt on the Pharaoh, expecting the some sort of hazard to go up on the Leech Seed. And now he has a free U-turn into Heracross, just a really nice play. The chip damage on Coco is annoying, but like this way, it prevents Meeps from double switching to predict the Heracross, so U-turn was a fine play. And Heracross just gets a huge hit off on something here. I think he decides to Rock Blast and does like 80 to the Coco. It does 16, 17 per hit. So Coco barely lives that, and Coco's only move to Oko Heracross is probably, I don't know if it's probably Z Wild Charge. But okay, he goes for Nature's Madness. And I don't know if Zutrez knew that he had a land on the back, and maybe he predicted him to not go for the electric move. I think Meeps predicted the Majorna slash Lando there with the Nature's Madness. But yeah, now Zutrez just goes into Landris here on the return. I remember this turn. And you see it's Rocky Hound Landris, which is not really that common at the moment. But yeah, you guys can see already, Zutrez, he's setting it up. He got up his rocks now. And Hawlucha is looking kind of scary, he's not gonna lie. So he sacks off his Heracross. I'm not sure if this is Specs Pelipper. I think it's Specs because it's Hydro Pump, yeah. You don't really see Hydro Pump on defensive Pelipper. So he goes into Coco here, and He just clicks Wild Charge again. So this is what this Coco sending out Coco does. It sets up Electric Terrain, which means if Coco dies, Hylucha gets a +2 boost. He already has Rocks Up and weakened the team. And the Ferrothorn stays in versus Coco. And what Zuchtriss does now is a really good play. He taunts the Ferrothorn. That means the Ferrothorn can't even leech it the Hylucha. He can only power with the Hylucha or like knock off it. Or Gyro Ball it. So Meeps probably could have switched out here. Because if by staying in with Ferrothorn, he gave the Hylucha free setup. But at this point, he was probably really tilted already. Yeah, my man Colin told me this play. We were talking about this game in chat. He said that Meeps probably should have switched out the Ferrothorn to not give the Hylucha free setup. I don't really remember what the play was. Yeah, I think he had to sack something, then bring in the Kingdra so Hylucha doesn't get free setup. And yeah, we don't know if the... Now he sends out the thing, the Pelipper first, and yeah, the Hylucha just wins. So I assume that the Lopunny just doesn't have Fake Out, because everything just dies. This might have Aqua Jet, but I don't know if he banked on a low roll there, or if he just... I don't know, he should have gone for Aqua Jet crit if he has it. Not sure, but yeah, he just got completely destroyed by this Hylucha. He was, yeah, like I said, probably tilted from game one, or I don't know. But yeah, Zuchtriss played out of his world, like, he played insanely wild. I have no idea who this guy is, like, we're gonna see a lot from him in the future. But yeah, Meeps is not out yet, this is double elimination. And yeah, the next game that is happening later is between Extra Shine and Updated Kanto. And I only got like a little bit of sleep, that's also why I can't really narrate well today. But I'll do my best to catch that game completely live, so that I can narrate better. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this. I mean, it's just a fun, quick, fast game. Like I really couldn't analyze it because they were playing so fast, and I also just... The first game I joined at turn 16, so I had to rewatch the turns. And when I rewatched the first 16 turns, they already finished the other turns. And this was a fun game for sure. Thank you guys for watching. Stay tuned for more ulti content. Yeah, Snake Draft is going on later. My man BTB wants me to record that, but I just slept way too little because of some personal issues, and I don't really feel like recording a draft that's super long. Unless people join me in call, we shall see. But yeah, stay tuned for Extra Shine vs. Kanto. It's definitely an interesting series. We'll see if Extra Shine brings his usual offense team or if he changes it up. And yeah, I'm still like blown away from this game. Like, I don't know what's, especially the first game, like, what was this? Like, this was like, look at this specific turn here. What one second was it? I mean, I guess he must have known Zuchtriss. Like, I don't know, this is just a godly play. Like, he U-turned on this into the Tren, and he went into Tren over something like type of lady that might have Psychic to hit the Mantan. So I guess that somewhat gives you the information that he might have Z-Nature Power. But that was just a crazy play here, Z-Nature Power, Bob. And like, he scouts for that, like, I don't know what, like, what a god. And with that godly play, I'm gonna end it. Just had to show it again. Bye.